Good afternoon and welcome to St. John the Baptist Catholic Church in Costa Mesa, California, to our Holy Mass in the Extraordinary Form, our Latin Mass. Today's Holy Mass is the 5th Sunday after the Epiphany. And these are the announcements. This Wednesday, February 9th, our school will host an information night here on campus beginning at 7 p.m. Please spread the word to any families you know who are looking for a great Catholic elementary school. That's this Wednesday, February 9th, 7 p.m. All young adults are invited to attend our next candlelight mass here in the church this Thursday, February 10th at 8 p.m. The evening will begin with adoration in the church at 7 p.m. and confessions will be available starting about 7:30 p.m. and then through the mass. This Friday, February 11th, we will have our next family night ministry event here at the parish. Dinner will be provided in the parish hall from 6 to 8 p.m. There are activities for all ages, including adoration in the church at 8 p.m., and childcare will be provided. The Order of Malta is having its annual World Day of the Sick Mass this coming Saturday, February 12th, at 10 a.m. at Christ Cathedral. Details are in the bulletin. Please check the bulletin in our parish website for other information and announcements. Today's Holy Mass is for the intention for the repose of the soul of Roberto Perez. Now the prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Asperges me. hosts and de nobis Domine misericordiam tuam. Domine exaudio rationem meam. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu
tuo. Oremus, exaudi nos Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens Eterni Deus, et mitere digneri Sanctum Angelum Tuum de Celis, qui custodiat foviat protegat, visiterat qui defendat omnes habitantes in hoc habitaculo, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Oh.
Gloria in excelsis Deo. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuum.
Oremus. Familiam tuam quesmus Domine continua pietate custodi, utque in solespe gratiae celestis initetur, tua semper protectione muniatur. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lectio Epistolae Beati Pauli Apostoli ad Colossenses. Fratres, induite vos sicu electi Dei, Sancti et electi, visera misericordiae, benignitatem, humilitatem, modestiam, patientiam, supportatis in visem, et donantes, vobis met ipsis, si quis adversus aliquem habit querelam, sicut ad Dominus donavit vobis, ita et vos, super omnia artem hec, caritatem habete, quod est vinculum perfectionis, et pax Christi exultet, en quoribus vestris, in qua et voctati, estis in unum corper, et gratias totae, verbum Christum habitet in vobis aberanter in omnis sapientia, docentes et commentes vos met ipsus psalmis, hymnis et cantisis spiritualibus. Gratia contentes in quoribus vestri Deo, onem quoncumque fecatis in verbo et un opere, omnia nomini Dominum Iesu Christi, gratias agentus Deo et Patri, per Iesum Christum Dominum nostrum.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Matteum.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
In ulle tempore dixit Iesus turbis parabolam hac. Simile factum est regnum celorum homini, qui seminavit bonum semen in agro suo, cum autem dormirent homines, venit inimicus eius, et super seminavit zizania in medio tritici et abit. Cum autem creviset herba et fructum feciset, tung aperuerunt et zizania. Accidentes autem servi patris familias dixerunt ei, Domine nonne bonum semen seminasti in agro tuo, unde ergo habet zizania, et ait illis inimicus homo hoc fecit, Servi autem dixerunt ei, vis imus et colligimus ea, et ait, non ne forte colligentes et sania, eradicetissimu cum eis et triticum. Sinite utraque crescere usque ad mesem, et in tempore meses dicam mesoribus, Colligite primum sitsania, et alligate ea in fasciculus ad comburendum, triticum autem congregare in horeum meum. Sir, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where did the weeds come from? And the man said, An enemy has done this. Cockle, tares, or weeds
can be easily mistaken for wheat until the ears appear. If it gets ground up with the wheat, it contaminates the flour, and any bread made from that flour causes severe nausea. In the East, revenge sometimes took the form of sowing weed among an enemy's crop. This is what happened in today's gospel while the lookouts slept. In 1948, when Catholic schools were confiscated in Hungary, when religion and prayer were banned from the classroom, we recognized the work of an enemy. In the 60s, here in our country, without any fanfare or public debate, while believers were asleep, a poisonous teaching was sown in American society, which, although disguised in the language of the First Amendment, was actually unconstitutional. Prayer and Bible reading in school were outlawed. Teachers and students were forbidden even to carry Bibles in school. School administrators leaned over backwards to stamp out religion in public schools. And history books were purged of things theological. Children came home thinking that pilgrims gave thanks to the Indians that first Thanksgiving Day. And 80 years later, we are still scratching our heads in wonder. Did not the founders of the Constitution sow the good seed of religious freedom? Why is religion accorded the same status as cigarette smoke? Perhaps tolerated in private, but purged out of public life. Why are our youth becoming more indifferent, even hostile to religion? What has this cost us? In the 50s, we were worried about smoking in school lavatories. Today, it is murder, rape, drug dealing, and shootings. This was all done in the name of separation of church and state, which sounds very constitutional, but is nowhere to be found therein. The First Amendment actually says, Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. First of all, this has nothing to do with our state government, let alone our local school district. For 180 years, it meant that the federal government could not become Catholic as opposed to Anglican, or vice versa. That is, no official state religion. But it also guaranteed every citizen's right to worship as they pleased, so long as their incense was not marijuana and they had no more than one wife at a time. According to the Supreme Court's reinterpretation of the Establishment Clause, not only the federal government, but even our local school district had to become agnostic, thus establishing agnostics an elite class within society and discriminating against all religions. Then in one of the greatest uncontested usurpations of power until the infamous Roe versus Wade decision, the Supreme Court proceeded to do what the Free Exercise Clause forbade even the Congress to do, to legislate against the free exercise of religion by forbidding teachers and students to express belief in God or pray at school. But why just teachers and students? Why not forbid politicians from expressing their faith in public? After all, presidents routinely end speeches invoking God's assistance. This is an inconsistency they are not willing to explain, because they knew that they would not be able to pull that one off for the time being. In public schools, our youth are taught that anything goes. Just don't get pregnant. We will show you how to avoid pregnancy, but do not worry if you do get pregnant. We will take you for an abortion, and your parents need not know a thing. Teachers can sin against innocence in 1,000 different ways, even murder your grandchildren, that is, the infant of your teenager. And yet students are protected from hearing their corrupting prayers. Who is offending whom? The point is, all these have happened. And as our Lord said, an enemy has done this. It just didn't happen. The devil sows his evil seed when Christians are asleep. Let us be vigilant and maintain our faith and morals in Christ and in his teachings.
Credo in unum Deum,
Thank you.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et
Sursum corda. Gratia sagamus, Domino Deo nostro.
Divinum et justum est.
Vere dignum et justum est, secum et salutare, nos tibi semper et ubique, gratia sagere, Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens, Eterne Deus, qui cum unigenito Filio Tuo, et Spiritu Sancto unus est Deus, unus est Dominus. Non in unius singularitate personae, sed in unius Trinitate substantiae. Quod enim de tua gloria revelante te credimus, hoc de Filio tuo, hoc de Spiritu Sancto, sine differentia discretionis sentimus. Ut in confessione vere semper te neque deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in maestate adoretur et qualitas. Quam laudan angeli atque arcangeli, cherubim quoque ac seraphim, qui non cessan clamare quotidie, una voce dicentes.
Thank you.
nobis quoque peccatoribus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, precepte salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimite nobis de vita nostra, sicut et nos dimitimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Sed libera nos a malo.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Thank you. Mysteria tua vestri omnipotens Deus et missis peccatis vestris perducat vos ad vitam aeternam. Indulgentia absolutionem et remissione peccatorum vestorum tribat vobis omnipotens et misericordiis hominibus. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato mundi. Domine non sum dignus et interes sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus et interes sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus et interes sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sanabitur anima mea.
Yeah.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritus tuo.
Oremus. Quaesimus omnipotens Deus ut ilius salutaris capiamus effectum, cuius per ec mysteria opinius accepimus, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivet regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Ite missa est. Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.